Hello YouTube, welcome to my channel. My name is Luis and in this video I'm going to install macOS Sonoma on my Lenovo M93P Tiny. So as you can see, I already have Monterey running and it works really well. I also have macOS Ventura on the same solid state drive, and also in the same solid state drive I'm running Windows 11. Okay, so three different partitions and three different operating systems in the same solid state drive. I also have attached an external solid state drive. This one was the testing with Sonoma, just to see if the computer was able to boot. Already made the test and it boots, so that is why I'm proceeding with this installation. And so as you can see, I only left one internal disk and one USB where I have the EFI with the OpenCore bootloader. Okay, so this is the EFI. You see I have three folders because every time I update one, I try to keep, if the EFI has space, the last one. So if I run with any problems, I can always revert to the latest working FI that I had on that USB. Okay, so let's wait for the downloading of Sonoma to finish. And okay, so the video will have some cuts and will be playing faster in order to be shorter in time. Okay, so I will be selecting which partition or disk I want to install macOS Sonoma. So I will install right now. And so once again, the video will be cut it and I will return when it's finished. Okay, so it's ready to proceed with the installation. So we will restart. Okay, so switching to my mobile phone, here we have the Lenovo M93P. So before it turns off, I cannot remove the external solid state, I already removed it. So proceeding with the installation now without the solid state drive external that was connected, and the computer will restart several times and this will take some time, so be patient. Okay, another boot, continue installation, and a little bit more. F12 again to access my BIOS boot, and then I can select my USB flash drive where I have the EFI with OpenCore. And now system is installed and I just have to put the password, and we see that there is no GPU, so we have to run the patch. So from Ventura to Sonoma you have to install a patch because this GPU is not supported anymore. So with OpenCore legacy patcher we will be able to run the patch to enable the GPU. Okay, right now you can see, so OpenCore patcher, and if you are subscribed to the channel you know that I have another Hackintosh Dell where I also made the installation for Sonoma and also had to patch the GPU, so the process was the same for that computer and for this one. So we are applying kernel extensions required for the GPU, and we need to reboot. Okay, so we received some warnings that some kernel extensions were installed. I'm just verifying if we need to manually accept, but I don't see anything, so let's just reboot, restart, and if everything went okay, we should have a full functional system. So the booting disk, it continues to say Monte, because it was previously it was Monterey, and that's the name I gave to that partition. And so we applied the patches and we still don't have a background, and the GPU, it's still not enabled. So right now what is missing, we need to update OpenCore, because probably some kernel extensions are outdated, and also the OpenCore bootloader is also outdated. So we need to mount DeFi. So I will do something like this. So I don't want to break my working bootloader, so I will mount the DeFi from my actual USB, and I will copy the one that is working to another USB flash drive, and I will do the updating on that one. So if something go wrong, I will still be able to boot to macOS Ventura, which I have on the other partition, and if everything goes okay, I can then copy this working EFI partition updated to my flash drive that I normally use to boot my Hackintosh. So right now we will select all the kernel extensions, check for updates, and for this I'm using OpenCore Auxiliary Tools. I only use this application to update OpenCore, and then get the latest version of OpenCore, click Start Sync, they all should go green, and then we just need to check if we have some errors and save. And now I will restart with the pen drive. This one is the new one, the black one with the new EFI that I just updated. Once again, F12, I will select now the pen drive with my new EFI, and I can see that the quality of the logo, the icons was already really nice, so probably it will be fixed already. Okay, yeah, so as you can see, we now have a running, so it is requiring a new restart, another restart, and we should have a full functional macOS Sonoma working on Lenovo M93P. So I just want to check also if the other partition with the macOS Ventura is okay, and it seems okay. So I'm logging in, the graphics is perfect, fast, everything is okay. So we need, I'm restarting, and now we have macOS Sonoma everything is working good. So what I will do again now is to copy the working EFI from the black flash drive to the one, the blue one that I have normally on the back of my machine. And I also keep, normally I keep always a backup. We never know if we gonna need it. So this is the EFI folder that I kept. We can now eject. Don't forget, if you enjoyed this video, to leave a like, and if you have questions, just write something or your question. I will try to reply to everybody. And just to show you that I also have Windows 11 working from one and only solid state drive, and this is the solution I have and is working really well. And I hope you enjoyed the video and consider to subscribe for more videos. Thank you very much. I will catch you on a new one.